Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss the case number one of Stadia method of tacheometric surveying, in which the staff is being held vertical and the line of sight is horizontal.
Before starting with the video, if you are new to the channel, then please subscribe this channel and click on the bell icon in order to get the regular updates.
Now, for example, if we have a flat TN on which we have 2 points on which the distances between them is required, then the instrument would be placed at one point and the staff will be held on the other point. Let's say that we are placing our instrument at point A and the staff at point B. And as I said, that the line of sight is horizontal and the staff is vertical. So then they will be making an angle of 90 degrees with each other. But in a case if we have an uneven TN like the one which is shown here, and it is being asked to calculate the horizontal distance between point A and point B, placing the instrument at one point and the staff at the other point like the one which is shown here, and this is the case in which the line of sight is horizontal. But here you can see that the line of sight is not striking with the staff. It means we cannot have the Stadia readings in this case. So then this case will not be used in such type of Stadia. Now let's discuss how the calculation can be done when we have this case. Same points, we are seeing the instrument at one point, staff at the other point. And when we are on field, as you know that when we are performing the tacheometric surveying, we have 3 different readings as upper, central and the lower Stadia readings. And as far as the horizontal distance between point A and point B is concerned, we have the formula as MS plus C, where M and C are the multiplying and the additive constant. And that depends upon the type of lens that we are using. And S is actually the Stadia intercept, which is actually the distance between the upper and the lower Stadia readings. Or you can say the difference between the upper Stadia reading and the lower Stadia reading. So once we have that upper and lower Stadia reading, then we can calculate the horizontal distance. But as far as the reduced level of point B is concerned, we should be knowing the reduced level of any point first. So the point where we have a known reduced level is actually the benchmark. And so at the benchmark, we will be having the backside reading first. Once we have the backside reading, then the calculation for the reduced level can be done. So first of all, we need to calculate the reduced level of the axis of instrument. For that, we need to add the reduced level of the benchmark with the backside. So once we have the reduced level of the axis of instrument, it means we are having the reduced level at this point. Now then we need to move downwards for this distance. Let's say that this distance is h. So as we are moving downwards, subtracting this h distance will give you then the reduced level at point B. Now let's solve an example related to this case. So in this example, it is being asked to calculate the horizontal distance between point A and point B, and also it is being asked to calculate the reduced level of point B. And that is given to us that the type of lens that is being used in the tacheometer is the analytic lens, and the staff is being held at 2 points, which is benchmark and the point B. Instrument station is 1, that is at point A only. And also the reduced level of the benchmark is given to us. So in order to calculate the required parameters, we need to draw the sketch first. So for example, this is the TN on which these readings are being taken. Let's say that this is point A and this is point B. And we are placing the instrument at point A and the staff at point B. Stadia readings are being taken at point B and also at the benchmark, and the Stadia readings that are taken at point B are the upper one is 2.25 and the lower one is 0.75. So as we know that in order to calculate the distance, the formula is ms plus c. And as far as the multiplying and additive constants are concerned, the type of lens used is analytic lens, and we know that in that type of lens the values are 100 and 0. So then the final formula for the horizontal distance would be 100s. And S, the stereo intercept, is actually the difference between these upper and lower readings. So the difference will then become at 1.5. So it will become 150 meter distance. So we have got the one answer, but still we need to calculate the reduced level of point B. And the reduced level at the benchmark is given to us. So let's say that the benchmark is being placed here, and the stereo readings are being taken at that point. But as far as the reduced level is concerned, the only value that can help us in determining the reduced level is the central one, and that will be the backside reading, which is actually the distance from here to here, that is 1.80. Now reduced level of point B will be equal to, first of all, we have the reduced level of the benchmark. It means we are over here. We know the level of this point. So in order to determine the reduced level of the axis of instrument, we need to go up. It means we have to add. Reduced level of the benchmark is 50.55. Adding the backside reading, which is 1.8. And once we have the reduced level of the axis of instrument, it means we are over here. And we need to go a little down this distance, and this distance is nothing but the central stereo reading, which is 1.15. so subtracting 1.15 will give us the reduced level at point B, and when you perform the simple calculation, you will be having the value of reduced level as 51.2 meters. So we have both the answers. So this is all from this video. Thank you for watching this video. I hope to see you in the next coming videos, and that will be related to case number 2 and case number 3. That's it. Thank you.